Warning, you have entered the realm of the gods. So give us your mind and your full attention.
So you say you deal with esoteric information? I never heard of such.
Well, you're in for a treat.
Blah talk, this is the blah talk.
I lean hell bay, dropping jewels every day.
Blah talk, this is the blah talk.
Metaphysical, we deal with the spiritual.
Blah talk, this is the blah talk.
I lean hell bay, dropping jewels every day.
Blah talk, this is the blah talk.
Metaphysical, we deal with the spiritual. So you claim to be a god?
Damn right I'm a god. The maker, the owner, cream of the planet Earth, father civilization, god of the universe. Wow, I didn't know that.
So tune in or lose, friend. All strategies apply mathematically. The information he drop is real powerful. So get your notepad, it's more than an hour full. Watch your jaw, the crew is watching talk. Indigenous to the land, wherever we stand. First world order, we bringing it home in the first quarter. Invisible lines don't apply, we cross borders. Silly rabbit, knowledge for gods. No matter where you resign, lodge, temple of Mars. So don't fret or proceed with hesitation. Just tune in to Blog Talk to get the information. Peace.
Whether you suffer from pain in your back, the aches in your knees, come on down and purchase you some ancestral tea to get rid of all the parasites, toxins, and fleas. Spiritual elevation for cosmic gravitation. So put away the patience, cause there's no time to be wasted.
Double MC is the abbot, more risk be the nation. land, black man's land, we got to have it. Restore the throne, eradicate the savage. When disaster strikes, actual facts you can't manage. Our fools on deck, sink ships like Titanic. Spreading fear across the land, causing unjustified panic. Amongst the brain dead zombies, grabbing the spits of bandits. While these wicked overseas collect residuals in a hammock. Corporate fruits forever remain rancid, poisoning to the mind, inflicting subconscious damage. I'm Melchizedek, moving through 50 states. Only transmittance, what the gods I relate. Mental alchemists, watch love conquer hate. I am in a golden rays above my head to figure eight. I'm Melchizedek, moving through 50 states. Only transmittance, what the gods I relate. Mental alchemists, watch love conquer hate. I am in a golden rays above my head to figure eight. Return of the ancient one, the Moorish Naga, the dragon rider, or breathing fire, generator, operator, destroyer, a self, lord and master, instructor, a Kama Sutra, practicing Tantra, a Kriya Yoga, a Kutalini, the resurrector, Shishuna, the eater, Pingala, awaken the seven chakra, to come the avatar, Muhammad the conqueror, putting sword to your jugular, send you to the ether, the water, air, fire, bender, the earth ruler, usher in a new era. In the saga, eyes filled with terror, eerie sounds of horror, reflection cracked mirrors, minds made feeble, dreams crumble, the curse tremble, thieves in the temple, raise the mental, beyond the four devils, you whack motherfuckers.
Peace to the God. You already know, man. Yo.
Bohemian wizardry, you fraud them thieves be killing me. The enemy is close, he wrote lies on our identity. I build like he who step, architect like Imhotep. Sun had the sun himself, the god deadly with the art. I spit dark with a slit heart. You can feel it in your bone marrow before the shit starts. Standing in the cold with a scroll that was written in gold. Behold the old glimpse that was never untold.
Infinite like the 8-7 dwelling in your melon. No felon, though the unrighteous say that I'm rebellious. I'm primal, my rhyme suicidal. I worship no idols. My style a load of gems going down in a spiral. You stuck in your root. My intelligence past my cool. The god is the truth. Every time I step in the booth, you stepped on a stoop. Got spooked and swooped in my loop. Due to knowledge, whack them seeds get played like flu.
It was the son of a saw, a gift from the gods for rule. Flying through the sky with golden wings, submerged into the light, knighted by the golden king with the scepter of justice. Melanin cultivating chi until we are Aetherians, finally becoming one with the righteous sun. Solar, souls are raw, magnificent glow with unconditional love. Scattered rays for days from the heavens above. Soul below, the souls trapped in the lowest depths of hell. Incarnated into 76 trillion cells. To break free, we must be refined. Masculine and feminine properties combined.
The devil is the author of confusion. 183,000 divisions and religions. Denominations, sets, codes, schisms, and isms. Though isn't it written in the Bible that Jesus spoke in parables? The scriptures and gospels aren't just historical. Many passages weren't meant to be taken literal. Most of it is allegorical, based on esoteric principles. Baptist versus Methodist, Pentecostal holiness versus Jehovah's Witness, Mormons versus Seventh-day Adventists, skeptics, atheists, and agnostics. Divine and cosmic tactics of the reptilians, lower fourth-dimensional aliens. So beware of the draconian Satanists. Though they aim to imprison all true beings through ignorance. Though we crush the head of Leviathan. Battle mind control, subliminal suggestion, brainwashing indoctrinations, using religious, politics, education, economics, health, and labor, entertainment, and war. No sex and law. In this chessboard game called life, we've all been pawns. Puppets on strings controlled by demonic spawns. You can't run with the devil and walk with God.
You can't run with the devil and walk with God. You can't run with the devil and walk with God. You can't run with the devil and walk with God. You can't run with the devil and walk with God. You can't run with the devil and walk with God. You can't run with the devil and walk with God.
Peace. Back again, your host, Dr. Alvin Bay, in the house for the radio, no doubt. Be back once again, and we want to give shout-outs to our co-hosts and co-hostess over the last week and few months. We have to give shout-out to Brother Jamal for being stead strong, Brother Elohim for being stead strong, and also my co-host, Brother Fahim Watrinel, or his new name, Tekosha. All right, El Bay. We want to give him a hand clap for being that strong, as well as my wife, the goddess, Kedera Elbey, for being that strong. And this is what we'll be dealing with tonight, is know thyself and the mastery of life. All right, that is the topic of tonight. And to get into the discussion, I'm going to have to bring on Brother Fahim Neff, my co-host. Good brother.
How I tell you, wash your ties.
Hey, Washington East, how you doing tonight?
Doing very well, brother. How you doing, God?
Doing well, doing well. We're going to get into it tonight, and we're going to do our thing. All right? And as usual, you want to give any shout-outs to anyone? Brother L, can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Yeah, I was asking, did you want to give shout-outs to anyone tonight?
Sure, I give a shout out to you, especially Brother Asawa Aling Nukapake Obey, and to his significant other, Brother Kadira Ma'at Elbey, and to Brother Amir Nassar Elday.
All right, no doubt. Give a shout out to Brother Amir.
Mm-hmm. And Brother. Abdullah El Talib Mosi Bay as well.
I say, you know you want to give a shout out to Brother Abdullah. No doubt about that.
Yeah.
All right. That's the etymology man himself. All right.
Oh, yeah.
So we're going to do tonight's discussion. Like you said, tonight we're going to be dealing with know thyself and the mastery of life. So we want to talk about like 7 habits to give up now in order to achieve happiness. This is self-happiness, and number one is give up our need to always be right. That is one of the problems that is taking place that I'm seeing in the so-called conscious community, which really isn't conscious because there's no moral base. They have no morality.
Mm-hmm.
Brother L, they don't know how to gauge right from wrong nowadays, yet claim to be conscious.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to be a downfall because really a person of such is really dealing with the ego. If you want to know the truth of that matter. So you have to learn how to give up the need to always be right. You know, and there are so many of us who can't stand the idea of being wrong. You know, always wanting to be right. Even at the risk of ending great relationships or causing a great deal of stress or pain, you know, for ourselves and for others. So it's just not worth it. So whenever you feel the urge or the need to basically jump into a fight over who is right and who is wrong, ask yourself this question. Would I rather be right or would I rather be kind? You know, is this really worth it or is it, you know, to cause a strain in my relationship? Just so that I can say I'm right, you know. So this is one of the things that we want to speak about and get into and get people to start thinking about some things. And another one, number two, would be give up our need for control. Be willing to give up our need to always control everything that happens to us and around us, situations, events, people, because really, that is a manipulative spirit that the individual has. And manipulation is nothing but another negative attribute of the ego. Right? And when we're talking about the ego, we're talking about the individual who has been relegated, their energy levels dominate the lower chakra, which is the root or base chakra, which is the reptilian portion of the brain. So they are trapped, essentially, in the reptilian portion of the brain, Brother L. So whether they are loved ones or co-workers or just strangers you meet on the street, just allow them to be. Allow everything and everyone to be just as they are. don't always have to go and try to say, well, I'm gonna make them do this. I'm gonna make them do that. You know, stop with that manipulation. You know, manipulative spirit. We always see how much better, you know, that will make us feel in the long run. You know, because only one that you can really control is yourself. Learn self-discipline. If you want to control someone or something, it would be yourself that you would want to indulge that principle first. And since that is a lifetime indulgence, that means you won't have time to try to do so with someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Right? What'd you say, Brother L?
Oh, yeah, that's true, brother. Because a lot of, like you said, a lot of people want to make them be like them.
Right.
You know? And they can, a lot of them, can, when they find out they can't really find, I don't know, somehow they can't accept that.
Right,
you know?
Exactly.
And all they're doing is exactly. Making themselves sick.
Right. You know, and as we always say, there's a chemical response that is released within organs that are emotional, mental, metaphysical. For example, in the genitalia, rejection. The emotion of rejection is stored there. So if a woman begins to have a fibroid, she will have to ask herself, what is it in which that she is feeling, you know, rejected? You know, what is it, a relationship in which that she had, which caused devastation or drama to her? The same thing for a male who has cysts on his testicles or have impotency. That's rejection. You know, so, you know, these are things that we have to question ourselves about. Anger is stored in the liver. You know, so what is it, you know, if you have a liver problems or issues, not able to digest your food and get rid of toxins properly because your liver has over 500 functions in the body, a person will have to ask themselves, what is it in which they are angry about? You know, hatred is stored in the heart. So they will have to ask themselves, what is it that they hate? If they have an angina or heart palpitations or panic attacks and, you know, heart murmurs and all these types of things, what is it that they hate? Or depression is stored in the lungs. You know, they have a respiratory issue. They have a bronchitis. They have an asthma. You know, they have all these problems with, you know, having all these lung issues. What is it that they are depressed about? You know, or they have a lot of stress on the brain. So they have a lot of issues, you know, with forgetfulness, which that can eventually lead to Alzheimer's or dementia, senility. Or a person might have schizophrenia, or whatever the case is. But that is coming from stress being stored in the brain, and there's no release for any of these emotional, mental, metaphysical causes, Brother L. And so fear is stored in the kidney.
Yeah.
You know, so if they're having kidney issues, they will have to ask themselves, what is it in which that they're afraid of? You see, so a good book to get is Louise Hay's book, Feel the Body, in which that she gives you a affirmation or decree, a prayer, in which that can help with removing those blockages. You know, for example, a person who feels rejected, they will have to say that I am courageous. I can face life on my own. I can be a force to be reckoned with as I move through life. You know, whatever the case is, you can make your own mantra in which that can help you. Person with liver issues, where anger is stored, I release all anger. I am happy. I am joyful. I want to live life, you know. For a person who hates, I release all hatred. I show love to all. I smell down into my organs. For the person with stress in the brain.
Causing strokes.
Right. Causing strokes or simply breathing, deep breathing, exhaling. You're simply saying on the exhale that you release all tension and that you want to bring light into your crown chakra. Be one of light. Fill up your body with light. Fill up your exhale with light. Person with kidney issues, release that fear. I release fear. I'm courageous. I'm moving forward in life. I'm better than ever. Every day, I get better. Or whatever the case is, whatever mantra that you come up with, you know, we here on the show have taught people how to relieve these issues by dealing with the vowel sound. For the crown chakra, we would do the eye sound. For the forehead, we would do the E sound. For the throat chakra, we would do the A sound. For the heart or sinus chakra, we would do the A sound. For the solar plexus, we do the Ha sound. For the liver, the Sh sound. For the kidney, the Ka sound. For the digestive system, the O sound. For the genitals, the U sound. We pronounce each one extended as if singing 7 times. Each one be extended as if singing 7 times, like for the crown. I sound will be extended and be sung 7 times like that. And then you will move to the E sound, to the A sound, to the A sound, Ha sound, Sh sound, Ka sound, O sound, U sound. And these vowels can help heal. These endocrine glands or chakra systems or orifices or light, which is known as the 7 lions or the 7 souls of Ra, also known as the 7 African powers, the 7 Loha, or Vudan, the 7 Vudan Loha, the 7 Yoruba principles, you know, the 7 Elohim, the 7 eyes of Allah. Whatever school of thought that you are from is talking about the same thing. All right, so another thing that we got to give up is blame. That was what got, you know, if you read the Bible, Adam and Eve, that was the blame game. Well, God, you gave it to me. We got to give up on the need to blame others for what we have or don't have. But we feel and don't feel. So stop giving our power away. Yourself. When something has happened, and start taking responsibility. Be accountable. Make everything right. That happens work out for the better. Even in Islam, on the day of Qiyam, which is the day of judgment, we stand alone to be held accountable for our deeds with no one to blame. Right, so number 4, I would say give up on self-deceiving self-talk. In other words, stop all this negative thought in your head. Repetitive, polluted, and self-deceiving whispers and thoughts that people have. You hurt. We hurt. And actually damage and damage ourselves when we listen to all those negative thoughts, which is essentially Shaitan, because Shaitan, or Satan, is known as the whisperer in the Quran, El Kanaz. And that is the thought that brings us down to destroy us. So we better than that. You are an amazing creation of God, of Ra, of Amen, of Allah, of Jah, Yah, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahuwah. Whatever name it is that you call, he, her, it. But let's fill our minds with love, mercy, and greatness.
Yeah. That's called the fasting of the mind and spirit and emotions. You know, that they have like a spiritual and mental and emotional cleansing.
Exactly, Brother Al. Yeah, you definitely need that. And it's sometimes hard, you know, to deal with, but I mean, you have to make it work, because ultimately no one is going to be blamed or have to be accountable except for us. You won't have to take responsibility if you just say it. So, you know, number five, we would say that basically give up on our limiting beliefs. Now, I see too many people coming into this so-called conscious movement, and they limit their beliefs. Their whole thing is that, I know this, I know that. And you don't know nothing. Every morning, you should wake up saying to yourself that you know nothing, that you're waking up in order to get what life has to give for you today, that you want to learn
right.
something new. You want to learn something new. You don't want to... you know, be limiting yourself. There's nothing we cannot do. There's nothing impossible for us to achieve. But we have to have the right mindset. We have the weapon, you know, of prayer, you know, which is affirmation, the decree, hakuz or hesi, words of power, the sound, you know, or the Bible says the word made flesh. Which is, all of this is based on the principle of vibration, which is the attribute of Tahuti, or Hermes Trismegistus. You know, we want to say that we are blessed with health and good faculty of an amazing mind and powerful body. So we have to stop allowing our limited beliefs keep us stuck in the wrong place. You know? Because we were meant for greatness. So when we tread in the footsteps of the greatest examples, you know, then you have a blueprint that you can follow. Right? Now, we have to also have to give up on complaining, but that is a serious attribute. That's real negative attribute that I see. Always complaining. You have to give up the constant need to complain about those many, many, many things, people, situations, or events that make us unhappy, sad, or depressed.
Right.
Because nobody can make us really unhappy. No situation can make us really sad or miserable unless we are alone. So whenever you go through something in which that will be strengthened to you, just simply breathe. The breath is everything in life. And this might sound far-fetched, but once again, as we always say, you can go without food for 40 days, you go out without water for 2 weeks.
but try to go without the breath for 3 minutes and see what happens. So the most important aspect of life is not eating. The most important aspect of life is not water. The most important aspect of life is not even sleep. Because you can go without sleep for 4 days. I wouldn't recommend it. But try to go without breath for 3 minutes. So the most important aspect about life, just by simple mathematics, is the breath. So Negroes can laugh all they want, but that's just what it is. So it's not a situation that triggers those feelings in us, but how we choose to look at it. So there's goodness in every situation. You know, this is a silver lining. You just have to see what's going on in order to get there. Because just because you can't see it doesn't mean that it's not there. All right, I remember there was a thing with the card that Allah planned and man planned, or they planned. And Allah is the best of planning for, you know, so in that regard, you know, you have to look at the greater plan that might be taking place. You know, because there's always something that's greater that comes after the storm. The sunshine always comes after the storm, right? And, you know, that's just what it is. And also, we have to give up criticizing, you know, give up the need of criticizing things, events, people. You know, that all different than you and think differently than you. Yes, we all are different. So that means we don't all have to think the same. All right? Even though we all have the same soul, which is the oneness.
Yes.
And we all want to be happy. We all want to be loved. And we all want to be understood. So our heart yearns for similar things, for the same thing. Ultimately, but it's our personality and our attitude in which that caused it to not reach its peak. And Allah, and that's a problem. So we have to stop criticizing and laughing at other people's faults and mistakes. You know, you have these individuals who come on to YouTube or people's timelines and they post information just to troll them and to try to get them upset or to get them angry. You know? So, this is just some of the things that, you know, we want to talk about tonight, and people trying to, you know, master self, know thyself. You can't master life if you don't know self. You have to know self. So this is just some of the ways that you can get to understand, understand anything yourself. I'm not even like that. You know, I'm talking in that way. But let's say understand. Right?
Before you know God,
you
gotta know yourself.
Yeah. Uh-oh, there you go. That's right. Well, that's the ancient Egyptian proverb, the Kemetic proverb, Sumerian proverb. It says, know thyself and thou shalt know God and the universe. That's the key. Okay. You see, there's so much that people have to go back and start analyzing so they can, so we can all help get this thing right. You know that the average lifespan is relatively short.
Yeah.
You know? So we know deep down life is short and that death will happen for all of us eventually. Yet we are in finitely surprised when it happens to someone we know.
That's why we know gotta make some things happen. You know, because like you said, you gotta stop complaining. Stop complaining. Okay, try to make some things happen. You know, the first thing is nationalization and doing other things after your nationalization. Surviving commerce, you know, you want to deal with the authentication of the birth certificate process, you know, things like that. Make some things happen. Don't complain about it.
Right.
Do something about it. You know?
Right. Well, that's the thing. So, you know, I'm not saying don't ignore death because you can't. But don't be afraid of it either.
Right.
You know, be afraid of a life you never lived. You know, that's what we should be afraid of a life that we never lived because we were too afraid to take action.
Right.
So death is not the greatest loss of life. The greatest loss dies inside while we are still living. While we're still alive, Brother L.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that is one of the things I talked about earlier today. A sister concerned death and what happens. You know, if we think that we've got a physical body, you know, and I did a video called I'm Only Human, you know, not too long ago. And that was because throughout the lecture I kept singing the song, which I can't remember who the band is right now. I'm only a human, you know, born to make mistakes. What's the name of that group, Brother L? You know?
The what now?
Name of the music group that made the song. Only human born to make mistakes.
Oh, I forgot. I've heard of the song though.
Yeah, right. I think it's the lead, if I'm not mistaken. The human lead.
I'm only human. But I can't think of it. Oh man, I can't. Oh.
Right. I think that's who it was. The human. I think it was the lead. Human lead. Or something like that. You know, I'm only human, of flesh and blood, a man.
That brother, man.
That was the human league. If I'm not mistaken, Brother L, that was the name of the group.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have to. Go outside, you know, of that nonsense, because you're more than just a fleshly body. But if you believe that you're just a flesh, then that's the downfall, and that's the reason why you see it. Because
right.
You actually only believe that you are just a physical body, the flesh and blood. Amen. So, since that is the case, you've done a disservice to the spirit, which moves this physical vessel, which is the breath itself. If it wasn't for the breath, you couldn't be able to move to absorb prana. The soul would either be indwelling within you if it wasn't for the breath of life, which is the spirit itself. You look up into the Webster Dictionary, you see that look up spirit, you see the word breath embedded inside the definition. You look up breath, you see the word spirit embedded inside the definition. Breath and spirit are synonymous. They're one and the same. So when the Bible states that God breathed into the nostrils the breath of life and made man a living soul, that breath of life was centrifugal and centrifugal force, which is that push and pull, that inhalation and exhalation force that gives structure and composition to your physical anatomy. You refer to it in ancient Egypt as Shu. Shu, the personification of air. Right? Who was the first begotten son of Atum. Just like Jesus was the first begotten son of God. Based on John 3:16 in the Bible. And then Jesus was the second Adam, just like which is mentioned in the book of Corinthians or Ephesians, up in there somewhere. And Adam, or Shu in his case, was the second Adam. And Shu means personification of air, as he says, it also means to be raised up. It also means dry. But his sister Tefnut means moisture. So it's talking about the breath, the inhalation and exhalation, the centrifugal and centrifugal force. The breath of life is what they represent. The inhalation and exhalation that holds your physical body together. And the atom group from the subatomic particles of the state of Nu, which is the water. And atom became molecule. Molecule became cells. And what is a giant molecule? It's DNA. Your cellular structure began, in which they're forming your tissues, your blood, your plasma, your flesh, your nervous system, et cetera, et cetera. Your muscles, your bones. That was your evolutionary process. Hence Eve, being made from the rib, from the left rib of Adam. So the left side symbolizes the feminine side. The magnetic side. So you have to understand, I'm saying, what these scriptures are actually conveying to us. It's talking about the human anatomy. Because Shu, which is the personification of air, is the same name of Jesus in Aramaic, known as Yahushua. It is also known in Hebrew as Yahshua, which happens to be the Old Testament deity known as Joshua, which is the English transliteration of the one who took the children of Israel into the land of Canaan, or the land of milk and honey. This is the land of Canaan. Because Moses wasn't able to go, but he was able to look over and watch. So Moses became a watcher. And he was able to watch the children of Israel go into the land of Canaan, the land of milk and honey. But Joshua took them in. Just like Jesus is able to take us into the kingdom of God later on in the New Testament. But what does Yahshua mean, which is the transliteration of the word Jesus, which is the Greco-Latin or Greco-Roman word of translation, where you get the word Jew, which is short for Jupiter, and Zeus. And Jupiter and Zeus was the two pantheon deities of the Greek and Roman belief system. And they put those two together to form Jesus and become Jesus. Once again, the centrifugal and centrifugal force of those two principles, once again, being shown. So Jesus symbolized those two principles embodied. Hence the word made flesh. And since his name is Yahshua. And remember, Hatun produced shoot from a sneeze. What is the sound in which that all of us make when we sneeze, Brother L?
There we go with the spirit, see?
Right. Right. Yahshua. We all make the sound, Yahshua, unless you're trying to stop it or something. You say, or whatever you do. But we all say Yahshua. And if it's real hard, Yahshua. And you So hence, Yahshua, which is the name of Jesus in Hebrew and Aramaic. But that happens to be the sound we make when we sneeze. And remember, Shu, who is the first begotten son of Atum, was produced from a sneeze, based on the ancient comedic text.
That's what I should have asked that brother when he said he never was spiritual. I should have asked him, do you ever sneeze?
Right, do you ever sneeze? All right. So this is the real science behind the breath of life. And so when Christians say that Jesus woke me up this morning, he sure did. Because that is the breath of life. And without it, you wouldn't have woke up. So you better be grateful to Jesus. Or be grateful, be grateful to Yahshua. All right. This is the simple etymology and science that is going on that was conveyed in the ancient Semitic text, which the Bible is nothing more than a summary of. So people want to throw the baby out with the bathwater, Brother L. No, you throw the dirty ass water. You throw the dirty ass water, out. You can let that go down the drain, but you get your baby from out the dirty water.
Exactly.
This is what he's talking about, and I am the universe in the chat room said Teflon is actually a spittle. So not only was from a sneeze, but from the spit, and of course when you sneeze, oftentimes you sneeze and, spit comes out your mouth or whatever, or particles called vapor or mist, which would be the moisture, which is similar to Teflon. And of course, newt is newt or nut, And stated that the French still, to this very day, still have retained the term nuit. And it says spittle of newt or nut, aka space dust or celestial dust, which remember, we are made from celestial dust. It's the formation of the body of Hatun. Adam was made from the dust of the ground, or the ground, just which is the earth itself, was made from stardust. Matter of fact, quantum physicists state that our body is more than 90% stardust particles and material. All right? And I Am the Universe also says, Lewis. In French, it's night. It's night. All right? So, this also correlates to triple stage darkness. You have Ein Sof and Ein Sof the Earth, which is symbolic to dark matter, while black energy, dark matter, all right? And ether, which would be the three substances, which is symbolic to iron, soap, and iron, soap, the earth, within the Kabbalah or Kabbalistic text, which within the woman symbolizes our transition into life from an amoebic, from an amoeba state to a zygote state into a fetus state to come out, from out of the darkness into light through a three. Trimester period. First 3 months, second 3 months, 33 months. And you come out the 40th week, which going into the 10th month, and 40 is the week, symbolic to Noah, another new or which symbolizes the word nos, which is a group from Latin, which means mind. All right? So we know that children reside within the abdominal area of the woman, right, baby, within the abdominal area, which the abdominal area is known as the abdominal gland. So Noah's Ark is actually us inside of our mother, which the belly arcs create that roundness. That was the arch, and it's that carrying the two, which is the two, which is the two ovaries. This can be fertilized with two eggs and separate four swings or more or less, which also correlates to the two breasts that you want to have. Okay. All right, so I just want to get that information in into the discussion also. All right, because this is something in which that we have to rectify, because people's souls depend upon it, because what they're really, what the scriptures are really telling you, that being that Yahshua means salvation, or Yahushua, which is Aramaic, which means, oh, he who saved, what is really being said is that the breath of life can save you. That through mastering the science of breath, all right, which is the word made flesh, you can actually form your golden body, which is your soul body, so that you can reside and live on after the death of the physical body. And that's how you are saved. You're not saved by going to church and hooping and hollering and falling out and all that nonsense that they have you doing. No, you have to make your celestial body. Right? In the book of Corinthians, it speaks about your territorial body, or your physical body and your celestial body. You have to form your celestial body. Like, this is what's going on here. All right, so you will only ever live the life you create for yourself. All right, your life is yours alone. Remember, the only other being you belong and are accountable to is your higher self, your mother of virtue, your God. Principles. Now, do you mean principles? Because you must have morality at times of life, or discipline. Now, others can try to persuade you, but they can't be, but they can't decide for you. They can't make you practice.
Right.
They can walk with you, but not in your shoes.
Right, you got to do it.
Right, you got to do it. But make sure that the path you decide to walk aligns with your own intuition and desires. And don't be scared to switch paths or pave the
right
way when it makes sense.
I mean, you nationalized me, Dr. Darlene, but you couldn't make me get nationalized. I mean, I asked you, I remember the time I asked you and Kadira, well, would that mess with my disability? Both of you told me no, you know, because I'm guilty of that. But it was up to me to make that move, you know.
Right. Well, you had to know. You had to know, and that's what all life is about, is us getting to know and realize that patience is not about waiting, but the ability to keep a good attitude while working hard for what you believe in.
Mm-hmm.
This is your life, and it's made up entirely of your choices. May your actions speak louder than your words, as they say, right? Or as the Father sent it to God's earth, the word is born. You know, I say, may your life preach louder than your lips.
Right.
You know, and may your success be your noise in the end. And if life only teaches you one thing, then let it be that taking a passionate leap is always worth it. You know? So even if you have no idea where you were going to land, be brave enough to take the step. You know? Even to the edge of the unknown and listen to your heart. And see, also being busy does not mean that you're being productive. Busyness isn't a virtue. And nor is it something to respect. You know, because we all have seasons of crazy schedules. Very few of us have a legitimate need to be busy all the time. You know? Shoot, I'm trying to get even more busy. You know, as busy as I am.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because being busy really equates to a productive day.
Right.
But we have to begin to start doing that.
Be busy all day and accomplish nothing, you know.
Exactly. And see, the thing is that we have to, you know, usually some kind of failure always occurs before success, because it's a test in order to see how much you want. How real are you to this? You know, and most mistakes are unavoidable in the beginning because you learn it. So you have to learn how to forgive yourself. It's not a problem to make them. It's only a problem if you never learn from them. If you're too afraid of failure, you can't possibly do what is needed to be done to succeed and be successful.
Right.
The situation, or the solution rather, to this problem is to actually make friends with failure. You want to know the difference between a master and a neophyte, a beginner. So who's an adept and a neophyte? You want to know the difference between that. The master has failed more times than the beginner has ever tried. Okay? So, we want to talk about that. And then also, thinking and doing are two very different things. Like, we have this think tank that we have put together, the Hillary Williams Institute Think Tank, or HWI Think Tank. But after the 11 sessions of thinking, you know, we're going to close it off and start doing and put into action the information which that we all have gathered. Because success never comes from to look for you while you wait about thinking about it.
Right.
You are what you do, not what you say you do. And knowledge is basically useless without action. Just like faith without works is dead. That's in the Bible too. So really good things doesn't come to those who wait. They come to those who work on a meaningful goal. Okay? But you don't have to wait. And another thing too, that we have a tendency of allowing our ego to swell because we lack the ability to forgive. And you don't have to wait for an apology to forgive. Life gets much easier when you learn to accept all the apologies you never get.
Right.
Right. So the key really is to be thankful for every experience, positive or negative. You know, it's about taking a step back and saying thank you for the lesson. It's something that I have to learn in this. And you also have to realize that grudges from the past are a perfect way for today's happiness. You know? So forgiveness is a because it really is a promise when you want to keep. But that's for yourself. So when you forgive someone, you're making a promise not to hold up a changeable path against your present self. It has nothing to do with freeing a criminal of his or her crime. But it has everything to do with freeing yourself of the burden of being an eternal victim. And this is the problem that we have with a lot of so-called people in the conscious community from a white man is the devil attitude, or, you know, we just victims of, you know, we take this victimization mentality. Not saying that it didn't happen. We know what was going on. We can see. Yes, eyes to see, ears to hear, thoughts to think. But are they helpful for you? What is going to be helpful to you? Healthy for you is the question. Okay? Anything you want to say, Brother L?
Yeah, I was thinking about the if anyone seen the Bruce Lee story, the story of Bruce Lee when he was a young boy, he's had a dream about this dragon.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people really didn't understand the movie, you know. They thought he was talking about this dragon. He dreamt when he was a little boy. But I told the people, I said, no, he was that dragon.
Right.
That was his lower self he had to conquer, which was fear.
Right, exactly.
In order to continue on, what are you trying to achieve in life?
Mm-hmm.
But he had to conquer that dragon, that kundalini, you know.
That's right. Right, he had to raise it.
He had to raise it up.
Right, if you don't raise it, then it's being stuck in that ego, in that reptilian brain, then, I mean, you know, you just spent the whole existence of life not living, partially living. You know, they said the kundalini is wrapped 3.5 times core at the base of the spine, and the person is half, and, you know, it's half asleep. It's half asleep. You know? So, we have to understand what's really going on. You know, we have to really dig deep and to know it. Right, and especially when we deal with other people and we're trying to have relationships, friendships, associations, some people are simply the wrong match.
Mm-hmm.
Some people you will only have to be as great as the people you surround yourself with. That is a saying or model of people who think richly. What is physical wealth, or if it's spiritual wealth. So being brave enough to let go of those who keep bringing you down is one of the things that might have to be done until they can learn the lesson. What is that you have to learn to release them? They have to learn that same lesson. So you shouldn't force connections with people who constantly make you feel less than amazing.
Right. Stay away from them type of people. Especially when you call yourself, when you really feel that you've done something or achieved something, that they've done something really great, and all they have to, and all they do is just put it down, put you down, you know, and really, person themselves, they're not what you call at peace with themselves, actually, you know.
They have the insecurity, and they try to put their insecurity in you.
Mm-hmm.
So if someone makes you feel uncomfortable or insecure, every time you book them, for whatever reason, they're probably not close friend material.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So if they make you feel that they're probably not close friend material, then you should, you know, really send them in that. And, you know, basically, they make you feel like you can't be yourself. But they make you feel like you're less than in any way, don't pursue the connection with them.
Right.
Right? because you'll end up feeling emotionally drained after hanging out with them.
Right.
Right. So listen to your intuition. Right. Listen to your intuition.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's so many right people for you. You know, who energizes
exactly.
you, who inspires you to be the best self. To be your best self. It makes no sense to force with people who are a wrong match for you. I'm not saying that you're going to be perfect in every way, with everything, but they're not criticizing you. They know they have faults. They're able to admit when they're wrong. You have to do the same thing. Remember, that's part of the first lesson that we just talked about. And being able to say you wrong and not have to always be right. So it's not other people's job to love you, it's yours.
Right.
It feels good when someone loves you, and you can, you know, think about, oh, you know, that's good. You know, now, you know, I love them because they love me. I have no choice because that's just how wonderful the feeling is. That's good. But it's important to be nice to others. But it's even more important to be nice to yourself.
Right.
And I don't mean nice to you. And I don't mean nice in the way of toxic meaning, which is ignorance. That is exactly what I'm saying, not to you. So you really have to love yourself to get anything done in this world. So make sure that you don't start seeing yourself through the eyes of those who don't value you. You have to know your worth, even if they don't. All right? Even if they don't, you have to. You know, as flawed as you may be, as unattractive as you may sometimes feel, or as incomplete as you think you are, yes, let someone love you despite all that, and let that person or that someone be you.
Mm-hmm.
Self-love is a great attribute that you have to have. Because if you give all your energy to something outside of yourself, that's idol worship. And this is what it's meant in the Old Testament, that God is a jealous God. Because you are adoring and admiring something outside of yourself more than you are with the God of sin, or with yourself. All right? And another thing, too, is that what you own is not who you are. Stuff really is just stuff. And it has absolutely no bearing on who you are as a person. Most of us can make do with much less than what we think we need. And that's fine, but, you know, we have to start analyzing it. You know, there's a Bible reminder, especially in this psychopathic, capitalistic, consumer-driven culture that focuses more on material things than meaningful connections and experiences. Right? You have to create your own culture. You can't do that by just watching television. Or reading fashion magazines, or, and consuming too much damn evening news, which, you know, if you look at the evening news, good gosh.
You ain't lying. You're talking about the morale. It's bad on your morale.
Exactly. That's bad on your morale, exactly. That puts you in a funk. Just watching that mess.
Well, you're not in good spirits. The evening news is not something for you to see.
Right.
I mean, that's all television is programming anyway. And then, you know, or then you, like I already said, you're in bad spirits, and then you're watching that mess. Man, that puts you even deeper into depression.
Right. Because happiness never comes to those who don't appreciate what they have while they have it.
That's right.
And as the saying goes, you never know what you have until it's gone.
That's right.
Well, as the song used to go, Clarence Carter, Jody done got your girl and gone.
There you go. You know. You realize to yourself, well, she wasn't a bad woman after all.
I think it was Clarence
Carter. It was me.
I know.
Not her.
Right. So basically, the only thing that's standing between you and your dream are your fears. So don't give in to your fears. That's basically what I'm saying. Of everything that I'm talking about here. And if you do, you won't be able to talk to your heart. There's only one thing that makes the dream impossible to achieve, and that's the fear of failure. Mistakes are part of life. Right? That's just what it is. But don't dwell in that. Either good or bad, nobody comes with a lesson.
Mm-hmm.
Focus on the lesson. What you must learn so that it won't happen again. Because if it, guess what? If it keeps happening, that means you didn't learn the lesson.
That's right.
Because when you change, the whole world changes with you.
And just stop making those same mistakes over and over and over again. You know, a person that I would say my age and he's still making them same mistakes, that means he haven't learned anything.
Exactly. Exactly, Brother Al. Yeah, see,
all they do, they just grow old. They never grow up, you know.
Right. And that's sad to see someone who's in their 60s who is like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I've seen it. I've seen it, Brother L, so I know you right in exact on that.
That is a sad sight.
Right. They're acting just like they did when they was 20.
Yeah. You can never bring those years back. You know, they're gone. I'm like Morgan Freeman when he said in the Shawshank Redemption, when he went before the review board for his parole, and he told him, he said, "Well, I can tell you, I'm not that young man no more.
Right.
You know, I like to talk to that young man and tell him what it's like, but I can't. That
right.
young man is long gone, and I'm all that's left of it."
Yeah, that was deep right there, Brother L. Exactly.
That was.
Yeah, that was deep. That was a good, yeah, that's why he had to get out.
I used that myself,
yeah,
what he said.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
I'm talking about certain issues. Yep, I sure do.
Well, that's because we have to become master of the mind. If our minds is peaceful and content, well, the world appears to be peaceful. In order to obtain peaceful disposition, first of all, one has to become the master of one's mind, in which basically we follow the direction of the Supreme Soul, which is our Allah, our God. And that's the reason why there must be remembrance of the higher self, of our Supreme Soul, of Allah, which is the original powers of the soul, and they must be reactivated in the mind and intelligent or intellect, you know, be in harmony. So if the mind is healthy, it obeys the orders of the intellect, then the body will also be healthy, and the tensions and the weaknesses of the mind will disappear. So this is what we mean by the mastery of self. It's the mastery of the mind.
Yeah.
And remember, we always tell you that the breath is the mind in action. So by mastering the science of breath, you master the mind. You can't think. With the breath, or without the breath, because the breath and the mind are one. Okay, so right, so we have to have some type of determination and focus and concentration. So one of the first steps to achieve peace is to develop the power of concentration. Concentration is that focus, that steady mind, which helps obey principles and orders. Mayat. You know, this sounds as an easy plan, but the power of courage and determination is difficult to obtain. This is where the determined thought to be peaceful is important. You know, Muslims say, at Udu be like the minute shake down at a regime. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the curse. You know, or accept for law. You know, Christians say, hallelujah. You know, or they do the Lord's Prayer.
Uh-huh.
You know, our Father in heaven.
Most of them don't know that.
That would be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Give us of our trespasses. If you give them who trespass against us, we do not anticipation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us from all evil. Deliver us from all evil. Divine, the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. So, you know, everybody has their way of saying it. But by combining spirituality, which is the science of breath, and the authority, which is the power of the mind, person will develop both controlling and ruling power through accurate judgmental power. And with this determination, it will always be success. For determination is the key to success. It's not the best method. This is the only method. Okay, so you know, I wanted to talk about that because people have a tendency for this greed for power, you know? In this time when the entire world, you know, was a place of what we refer to as peace or purity and prosperity, at least much more than what it is now, because even in Africa, there was no tale of a jail or prison system. But now here in the United States, we have the largest prison industrial complex in the whole goddamn world. More than France, Russia, England, which is Britain, Italy, Spain, combined.
Wow.
Here. So now we're witnessing chaos and confusion. Stress and strain, disunity and discord everywhere. You know, they capitalism has a brother fighting against another brother for wealth. And one religion is at war with another. And history shows that the majority of the wars of the world have been fought with one religion, which is greed. Greed for power has made politics a gamble for the throne. And who sits on the throne, Brother L?
Pope.
Bingo. So today the seat of secular power is nothing short of a throne of thorns, if you want to know the truth of it.
I heard he's supposed to be back over here next month.
Yeah, for sure. That's what I heard too.
So, you know, something's
right,
going on. You know, he's been over here year before last. He was just here. Now he's coming back this soon?
Well, remember, that was during the Obama administration. So now he has come over for the Trump administration to give him blessings. Remember, Trump was at that roast And who was Trump around? Who was sitting around Trump that whole time was some Catholic priests. If you go back to that roast that Hillary and Trump had earlier during the presidential debate, when they had that roast, you know, so you know that's what's going on.
Well, I'll tell you something right there.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
Come back when he come back next month. Some more heads gonna roll. I don't know.
Right.
I don't know who.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna come here to clean the books again.
Right, right. But see, that's because when Muslims say or Muslims say Islam or Assalamu Alaikum. Peace is a natural quality of the soul. It's the inner quality. The soul possesses three powers or faculties, the mind, the intellect, and the subconscious. And of course, the subconscious ranges into superconscious, magnetic conscious, infinite consciousness. You know, so the natural habitat, the habitat of the soul is actually peaceful, silent, salutary, you know, quiet. So deep within us is peace. You know, so the basic qualities and attributes of the soul are peace and silence. So that's why we want to activate the soul principle and free the soul from distraction. The peace of mind, you know, as they say, is disturbed by devices, anger, greed, ego, lust, hatred, attachment. And to regain peace, you have to overcome those vices. So once the soul is under the influence of the body, some of its intuitive powers, you know, become weak. You know? And follows the dictates of the senses and the body consciousness, which is interpersonal and intrapersonal consciousness or life consciousness. And that's what's going on. But the soul, as we know, you know, is beyond the attraction of sound and away from the influence of the elements. The soul is very powerful. It has all the original powers and innate virtues. That is the higher self. That is the God portion of ourself. You know, so we have to master these things. So spiritual power is the key to inner peace. You know, and this is what we're talking about tonight is, you know thyself and the mastery of life. So to claim the power of peace, basically to embrace the fundamental principles of spirituality, which is the mastery of the science of breath. So we have to examine our thoughts, our feelings, our motives, our behavior, our actions, carefully and honestly. And criticize ourselves so that you don't have to worry about others criticizing you. Because we're already doing it. We're already making those proper corrections within our nature. And the more we do that, the more we release ourselves from negative spiritual attachments or entities known as the archons. These archons are these negative spirits can attach themselves to the auric field and create leaks and holes in your auric field. So we have to examine our thoughts and feelings and motives carefully and honestly and avoid wasteful and negative thoughts, especially gossip.
Right.
Which spreads disquiet as well as anger. So basically today, everybody believes that the other person is at fault and is the cause of all problems, but it's everybody else. It's always the other person. No one wants to change, you know, their behavior, their actions, but they always want to give advice to other people.
Right, yeah.
But really, to initiate peace in our lives and in this world, it's important to realize that we should set the date for self-transformation, to live within peace and harmony, under the laws of Mayat, balance, reciprocity. Okay? We have to do that. All right? We're going to open up the phone lines for those that want to call in. This is a call. All right? At 563-999-3738. That's 563-999-3738. Once again, 563-999-3738. And Brother L, I'm going to a song here, and then when we come back, hopefully you'll open up the lines if there's any questions.
All right.
Take them down. All right.
Yeah. ATD, above the dome, trap of freedom, the family, tradition, heritage, the missing links, spiritual miracles, the awakenings, the walking sphinx, the time to eat, food for thought, the meta magician, holy rainwater flows off my altar, channel through the seasons, elevate the reasons, what's the purpose of life to the living, death to the conscious, at the end of days, clash of the titans, zombies running rampant, Christ in the pamper, looking for a lamp, revving at the church, plugging in the amp, rock of the ages, son of the undead, vamping, immortal rage, I bleed red ink on the page, words and truth, no signature, to the blur, from invisible literature, sitting at the dock of the bay with Otis, having rituals, turn the lights off, it can get real quick, sir, melt and pot mix, I'm in search for a fix, walking backwards, looking forwards, patiently waiting, don't ignore it, holding true swords like peace signs aimed at your board. Into flight, hawk eyesight, interdimensional terabytes, fuel for the journey, some lay a fuel for the gurney, colored in the book of law, no need for attorney, I turn the page, feel the script like a doctor coming out the cage, I'm the lion, fed grain, sticks and stones, no pain, a worker's only worth his gain, attempting to keep my inner sane, with lifestyle changes, highs and mountain plains, seven thoughts, seven vaults, no faults, who's to blame? It ain't the same, they take your names. I feel the sun, it ain't no fun if the homie can't have none. I see you run like who's fame, lightning. It seems frightening, exciting. I go with streaming lightning. I'm the Nick and Loki at night.
Like what a magician, that's Brother Elohi, every Tuesday, tips and tricks. Him and his co-host, Brother Jamal, either one of the two will be on every Tuesday at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, all right? So, check them out, that's them. We have a group, it's called the Nagas, in which that was the second song that we played at the top of the hour of 8 o'clock, of course, as we was coming in. So, want to open up the phone lines or chat into, or get into the chat, some information in the chat area here. I am the universe. He's always getting some good info and stated that hallelujah equals the sun. All right. And also, stated, don't forget Russia and China, of course. And I said Russia, I didn't say China. And also, he was in Philadelphia. I'm talking about the Pope, that is, take inventory. And the prophet is very well aware what Philadelphia entails, which is brotherly love, and implies a bloodline. All right, all right. Appreciate that. I am the universe. Always coming on, checking this out, and always giving that pertinent information. If I miss something, you hook me up right with it. That's what I'm talking about. We have to lift each other up. Sword, sharpen sword, as they say. Still sharpen steel. All right, so you want to get that number out once again. And the number is 563-999-3738. Give us a call if you have any questions. We're going in on some things. We had to take a pause for the real deep metaphysics in which that we normally talk about, in order for people to get the basics. All right, because that's what we want to talk about. And we talked about forgiveness, also learn to control your thoughts, learn to control your emotions, because emotions make, as the Egyptian or Kemetic Sumerian proverbs state, that emotions make good servants but poor masters. All right, so we want to make sure that we understand that. All right, so you can use your emotions, but it's not good to put them in the forefront. So you want to take life seriously enough, but not, you know, you want to learn how to laugh at little things, do that, but, you know, and everything will be much easier, because life can be simple. It was designed that way, you know. We make it hard.
Right.
Because you're following someone else's indoctrination and dogma. Right? So the more we think about life, the more meaningful it is in one aspect, but then in some aspects, the more meaningless it becomes. Because life really has no purpose except for the purpose we give it.
Right.
And what is it? It's a simple choice. Right? Turn left, right? Go backwards or forward. You know what I'm saying? So when you lose sight of that, you miss the freedom of the options we have. You become fearful and anxious. And this is basically what was being told to Neo and Morpheus and Trinity when they met up with the Frenchman, you know, in I believe it was part two of The Matrix. When they were having that conversation before he went to the bathroom. Right, so we want to have positive thoughts. When to think positive, a mental attitude, positive attitude is correct in basically any and all given situations. Right, because once again, only anger hurts you, only hatred hurts you.
Yes, it does.
If you're not doing anything to that individual, anything you're doing is hurting you. So, you know, it's basically is an extreme optimistic notion that everything goes well just by looking at the bright side of things. Rather, it is a conscious way to replace negative thoughts that lead you nowhere with positive thoughts, allows us to realize ourselves. That's really what's going on. So it's time to basically practice every moment until you replace self-doubt with confidence. It becomes a habit. And as a muscle gets stronger, when you exercise it, so does the mind. Right, so we have to look at it in that way. Right, and that's what you're talking about with the forgiveness. Remember that you do not forgive the other person, you know, but you get rid of anger, negative thoughts, to stop being loading damage. But you have to keep the mind, keep in mind that they act the way, you know, they act that way, you know, because that's where they have the insecurity. That's their issue. Right? So we talked about that you have to learn how to control your thoughts. And thoughts are things. And your thoughts are the first step to making things happen. So while the human mind is described as a stream of consciousness, that does not mean that you cannot decide where the direct current is flowing. You have to. You have to decide on where it's flowing. And you have to learn how to control your emotions. And the only person who can make you unhappy is yourself, as we spoke about earlier.
Exactly.
So you also, and you also have to basically limit the loss of time online. You know, I mean, now you can be on the internet, you know, which is an awesome tool, all the time. You know, on Facebook, you know, Twitter, you know, Instagram. But now, being that I'm working on my book and getting ready for certain things, such as this lecture that I got coming up in a couple of weeks, as well as also, you know, next month's event, you know, here on the land. Matter of fact, for those interested, call us at 910-364-9099. That's 910-364-9099. And March 17th, 18th, and 19th, we'll have our event. Our annual event will be going on. And all this information that you're privileged to on the radio for the last 5 years, 6 years, you will see it live up close and personal, along with other brothers, such as my good friend here, co-host, brother Tecumseh L. Bay, Rutran Fahim L. here. You will hear him. He will also be giving his lecture and speech. You will have several speakers and lecturers to engage and help uplift all humanity. So come out for the three-day event. It's only $200 for 3 days. That will drink and will food. We don't provide the hotel stay though. Even though if you call early enough, you can get a room at the Bread and Breakfast or either set up a tent on the land. So if you know how to rough it a little bit, and you got your sleeping bag and you got your tent, then you come on out, check us out. That's 910-364-9099. All right, so come on out to the event. You got 3 days of the most powerful information on the planet Earth. We'll be doing Qigong, Tai Chi, Reiki, Pranic Energy Healing, Shaolin Kung Fu, so many different other, so many different things we'll be doing. Astrology, herbology, numerology, everything you can think of, acupuncture. Acupressure, massage therapy, all right, reflexology, virusology, you know, we're going to try to get anything in game that we possibly can. So come on out and enjoy yourself, learn some of this highest information. This is the highest information on the planet that's giving out in 3 days. You bring your video recorders, bring your pen and paper, you know, bring your family members. Most important, bring your friends and associates. Well, tell everybody, go and spread the word. But what's the way to happen? Down's power. All right, so you want to keep that in mind. All right, so come on out and check this out, Sean, because you want to make this clear. All right, so you think you're going to stick with the L?
Yeah, like you were saying, we're going to be getting it in, you know. So come on down and check us out. I'm planning on being down there for the second time. I was very impressed the first time. So I want to go back down there again and do it again. Let me say, let's do it again.
So. Do it again. That's right. Sidney Poitier and Bill Cosby.
Right.
Right. You know, let's do it again, y'all. All right. So, come on down and check us out. Once again, that's March 17th, 18th, and 19th. This is on the spring equinox.
Yeah,
it's on spring equinox.
Lot,
right.
A lot to learn.
Right. Right. And you will be going into it. All right. So let me go to the phone lines and see if there's anywhere talking. No, someone's talking. I forget. No one's calling on. Like, no one's saying nothing. All right. Okay. Here we go. Maintaining the balance needed. I didn't realize because going off would have such a massive effect to the collective as whole. Okay. All right. Miss Hall just wrote that, and that's what it can have, because people have to start analyzing their behavior and their motives, their actions, because the actions, you know, which are impure, negative, and unclear, and actions which are pure, positive, and clear, you know, saying, so you have to make a distinction, right? Because impure actions are those that are influenced by negative intention, anger, ego, bitterness, fear, rage, revenge, lust, attachment, dishonesty, greed,
yeah,
Satan, jealousy, etc. You know?
Everything that harms.
Oh, say it again, brother.
Everything that harms.
Right, which is what? The lowest self, right? Right, so positive actions are influenced by good intentions and attitude. You know, they are basically actions moved by kindness, forgiveness, love, joy, peace, humility, generosity, sweetness, empathy, someone who's sympathetic or who empathizes, trust, unity, etc. So, you know, we have to make a distinction. And then, you know, you also have neutral actions, which are not dictated by negative or positive consciousness, but it does not cause a negative or positive result. Everything remains as it was, you know? So we have to look at people's intentions. You know, of course, these are just some of the rules that you have to have, you know, for happiness, you know? I think too many people, you know, always feeling sorry for themselves. They're not grateful. You know, always complaining. That's what we were talking about before. You know, you have to stop complaining so damn much. You know, of course, complaining isn't going to get you anywhere.
Nope.
And you know, self-pity is our worst enemy. And if we yield to it, we can never do anything wise in this world. Okay? That's just what it is. And see, we have to begin to start being more grateful. You know, you have your health, you have maybe your home, your friends, you have your heart, your brain, your spirit, your soul. You know, these are all amazing things in our lives that, you know, we have our smile, we have joy, happiness, if we want it. So,
yeah, that self-pity thing is pretty bad. That's a waste of energy.
Right.
The worst energy or the worst thing you can do to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, no, I mean that oof. Well, you never will be able to do anything or make anything happen.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll turn into drinking, turn to alcoholism or drug addiction, you know.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
to make yourself feel good about yourself. Well, that should already be in you, you know. Because how are you going to, you can't make no one happy. They have to make themselves happy. And then when you come into their lives, then anyway, you don't have peace within yourself, then you bring the discord and disharmony among them.
Right, right. Because many brilliant and talented people have basically destroyed their own success because they lack courtesy and manners, Brother Al.
Yeah.
Lightness and courtesy are signs of being cultured. Rudeness and discourtesy shows the lack of it, and treat other people with respect and dignity goes a long way. You know, but rudeness is basically the weak man's intimidation of strength.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Or imitation, you know, of strength. That's what it is. A weak man has to imitate strength by rudeness. You know, so we want to understand what's really going on, understand what's really going on.
Mm-hmm.
And more understand what's taking place. You know, when you look at, you know, people in Hollywood, you know, people that you just were seeing 5 years ago on everything are no longer even being seen because you hear word of those in Hollywood saying that this person is hard to work with. This person has a bad attitude. You know? And not saying that Hollywood is a cultured place to be at because it isn't, but we just giving an illustration. You know, we already know, you know, what takes place behind closed doors up in there, you know? But you talk about for those who were there and what they was doing and the success that they was having, you know, but now you don't even see them.
No, you don't. I don't know whether it's because they refuse to go through those rituals or not.
Right, right. Could be because they didn't go through the rituals. Exactly, Brother L.
So I'm saying, well, I ain't doing that. You know, no, I ain't doing that. So you don't see them no more.
Mm-hmm. That's one reason. And then other times it could be that the person just has actually just have a bad attitude.
Yeah, that could be it too.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I know a lot of them, you know, you see them, they be pretty successful in the movies or whatnot. Next thing you know, you see them on some kind of commercial, you know.
Right.
Commercials, you know.
Right.
Or you might see them wind up on soap operas.
Exactly. When they were just, you know, doing so much. They were doing movies.
What happened, you know?
Exactly. Right. You start out going to a commercial and then going into television and then movies.
Exactly.
You don't go from movies down to no damn television. I mean, down to no commercial. You
right.
Do a movie, a 2-hour movie, down to a 3-minute commercial.
Right. So what happened?
Okay. Right, right.
What is it that you didn't want to do? Were you hard to get along with? Or was it something you didn't want to do in order to further your career?
All right. So now we also want to talk about 4 things that make your body sick. Number 1 would be excessive talking. Number 2 would be excessive sleeping. Number 3 would be excessive eating. Number 4 would be excessive meeting other people. All those different energy fields, you know, a person will have to become accustomed to rather quickly. Sometimes you can't adapt that quickly. And there's 4 things that destroys the body. Number 1 is worry, sorrow, which is sadness and grief, hunger for food or water, and sleeping late, you know, going to sleep late. You know, you have to have Based on melatonin and serotonin production, melatonin is produced from 11 to 7 a.m. in the morning, serotonin from 7 a.m. to 11 p.m. at night. The melanin begins to start flowing around 1:30 a.m. in the morning for melatonin. So you want to be able to get that good melatonin cycle and be in bed if you possibly can. Sometimes I can't even do it by at least 1:30 if possible in the morning so that you can get that that melatonin. All right? So just keep that in mind. And all right? I'm gonna call it a night, Brother L. We're about reaching the climax of the time here.
All right.
All right, and are there any closing statements, bro? What you got?
Well, you got it in tonight, so.
Okay. Okay.
Got it in.
Well, that was cool. Right.
Probably a lot most of probably got some callers, but they probably just wanted to listen tonight. No.
Right. We ain't go too deep. We dealt more with practical stuff. Which is a good thing because we need to.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So I say we can get it in next week.
All right. Well, once again, y'all. Yeah. We want to thank y'all for
the same station.
Exactly. Yeah. And we want to thank y'all for coming and checking us out. We love y'all and we appreciate y'all when y'all come. So keep listening in and we continue doing our thing. And we have no choice but to uplift all humanity. As far as humanity has fallen. It's time now for it to be lifted up. And so we will try to continue doing our own job here. Our mission, our purpose. I know I can speak for myself and Brother Al. You have to speak for yourself. And see what you can come up with to be an asset to this listening. Or you being distributed to the being crap in the barrel mentality. Like I've been seeing a lot of these trolls on these timelines and posts and texts and different things on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. Of course, again, somebody doesn't agree with everything that you say. Or you feel like that is out of character. Or we don't agree with it. Please criticize and you complain. Well, comes a time where, like you said, you're going to have to come beyond, that. And this is the time of death. So, we want everybody to remember that March 17th, 18th, 19th, we have our event coming up. Give us a call, 910-364-9099, or go to the website, drlbay.com, to the section, calendar of events. And then you will find the agenda as well as the hotels and also everything in which that you're trying to accomplish. So give us a call, 910-364-9099, for this 3-day event. All right, we out y'all. Love y'all and this is my man, Brother Ron Nessa.
And much love. Peace.
I I don't need to be a dope boy, my poetry is dope enough. Trapping interstellar while my third eye open up. See through all the lies that y'all tell it with a straight face. Return of the luminous ones. Y'all better make way to find a chapter. Find a collapse on all you politicians. They politicking how to lead a world no pot to piss in. The way I think is more deepen in the Grand Canyon. I guarantee this black man would be the man standing. My premonition matched the old man calendar. It's always accurate like a lightweight challenger. For all you wicked witches and the Wizard of Oz, you and that man behind the curtain, yeah, y'all fixing the fall. Only a matter of time before shit hit the fan. Here's an idiot's guide for you on how to get a man. I don't need a bunch of homies to ride or die with me. I can call on Hey Roo to fly the skies with me. We going through the transition and the thoughts she wrote. Put on my uncle, gave my Jesus Christ back to the folk. Came back, my angel time to pray heaven on earth. I was the last daughter child that returned to the earth. We going through the transition and the thoughts she wrote. Put on my uncle, gave my Jesus Christ back to the folk. Came back, my angel time to pray heaven on earth. I was the last daughter child that returned to the earth. When I'm riding on this city streets, never really miss a beat. To the point of no return, lest I turn another cheek. Catch me on my dated box, smooth as I wanna be. Just being me, never chilling with the wannabes. God in the flesh, dated bad sister latches. But cosmic history is more than they can understand it. My melanated skin, starburst from the astro. I'm made of dark energy, created from black holes. Know thyself, the only one you can lean on. I got some scoopers that y'all can break y'all weed on. All right, here's Martin Luther King and slave ships. But what about the underwater cities and spaceships? My mystical mind, we had the government covering. But if the old man temple fly away like a mothership, where African people wear the real Anunnaki, wearing feathers on their heads just a few feet taller than me. We going through the transition and that's all she wrote. Put on my uncle, gave my Jesus Christ back to the pope. Came back, my angel time to pray heaven on earth. I was the last daughter child that returned to the earth. We going through the transition and that's all she wrote. Put on my uncle, gave my Jesus Christ back to the pope. Yo, don't look at me the same, I ain't nothing like I used to be. Upgraded daily through the lies and all the foolery. My dream became lucid, I travel back in time. Collecting life data for my subconscious mind. That father let me know that anything is possible. By pulling down the universe through my crown chakra. Manipulate the energy is all an illusion. Knowing who you are kills all the confusion. Why 85% judge off my appearance? I use alchemy to create the world potential. My lyrics turn divas right back into queens. Why those boys are saying twice appearing back on the scene. Everybody gone mad, blaming media outlet. The new black Hollywood chosen straight out of the project. Global agenda war sucking up to the master. While the whole community going up in disaster. We going through the transition and that's all she wrote. Put on my uncle, gave my Jesus Christ back to the pope. Came back, my angel time to bring heaven on earth.